Hey everybody, in this video we're talking a little bit about the July visa bulletin and some of the stuff that we've seen change and some good news if you're from India. Check out the video. Hey everybody, the July visa bulletin is out. Lots of great news in the employment-based categories. Now you know we specifically watch the visa bulletin in the two different charts. We have the final action dates up at top and the filing dates down below. This has been very, very helpful because we get to see when we can file a case, become in a period of authorized stay, and then when these cases look like they're going to be finished and actually end with a green card. So right now, we saw a lot of movement in the final action dates. That's the top chart, which is telling us the people who are literally allowed to receive their green card based upon the date listed. Now, both China and India moved forward in EB2 and EB3 categories, but for India, we saw some major, major movement. Specifically, in EB2, we saw a six-month move forward, meaning 6 months more of individuals are now eligible to get their green card now. And on the EB3 for India, we saw a huge jump of 14 months, I think 13, 14 months forward in that category. Now, what this really means, and this kind of coincides a lot with all the information we get from the Department of State when they do their weekly, monthly broadcast, what they've been saying to us, we can see now what's happened, is they block out the amount of visas they have per year and they kind of have it ready. And as they get to the final quarter, which they're going to do now, okay, because the government calendar ends on October 1st, the final quarter runs July, August, and September. They're seeing how many visas they have left, okay, unused visas. They're seeing spillover or carryover visas, and they're seeing how do we try to use these all up. Now, we've told you in videos before that sometimes they end the year and there's some 20, 30,000 unused visas. They're trying really, really hard to get all those visas allocated and put out. That's why we see the massive jump, okay, on the final action dates. That means that USCIS is going to be trying to approve cases before October of people who've been waiting for a long time and are now eligible. So we should see a lot of movement on that, especially in EB3 India and EB2 India, where the movement was so dramatic and so big that a lot of people are now eligible to get green cards. There's nothing you can really do. You can't change or move your case forward. All you can do is if your filing date has come, you should have filed your case. And at this point, we're seeing everything move forward where we have a opportunity to win the case. So India's EB2 and EB3, major jumps forward. We're in the final quarter of the government calendar. We should see approvals coming out. What you're really gonna find a huge benefit is if they're gonna waive those interviews or just ignore the interview requirement, which I have seen happen, or they'll schedule interviews using a remote process. Either way, it's a speed up of the process because getting the green card approved is super important now at the end of the year with all those visas available. So it's very, very good news for all you guys out there. I can't really do anything for you. You can't really do anything. Make sure your case is filed. Make sure if you have an RFE, you respond to it right away. Try to be active and involved with your case now because the year is ending. All right, that's a lot of information for today. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave us a like or subscribe or a comment down below. Is your case pending? How long have you been waiting? What is it you want to know about the process? We try and make videos that help you guys out. Stay well out there. Bye.